Hi, my name's Dr. Sarah Beatty, and I'm a fourth-year audiology extern here at the House Clinic. I'm here to talk with you guys today about what to expect at your cochlear implant candidacy evaluation appointment. So first and foremost, let's start with what is a cochlear implant? A cochlear implant is a device that helps people with moderately severe to profound sensory neural hearing loss. It consists of two parts, an internal implant and an external speech processor. Let's take a deeper look at these two components. So the internal implant is surgically implanted by a physician into your inner ear, or to be specific, your cochlea. It's a 90-minute outpatient procedure under general anesthesia. The external sound processor magnetizes to the internal implant, and it picks up the sound via a microphone and then transmits that sound to the internal implant. In order for you to be able to hear with the cochlear implant, you have to wear the external component. Without it, you do not hear. So first, let's take a look at how we normally hear. So there are three components of your ear. There's your outer, middle, and inner ear. The sound travels through your outer ear, down your ear canal, and it vibrates your tympanic membrane or eardrum. That vibration of the eardrum causes the three tiny bones in your ear, or your middle ear, to vibrate, which then causes the fluid in your cochlea to displace, which stimulates the hair cells in your cochlea, which sends the signal up to your auditory nerve and to your brain to allow you to hear. Because we ultimately hear with our brain, not our ears. Now, one thing to note when we look at normal hearing people versus people with hearing loss is people with normal hearing, as you can see in this picture, have numerous hair cells in your cochlea. And when those hair cells are stimulated, they cause the nerve to be stimulated, sending that signal to the brain. If you take a look at the picture with the damaged cochlear hair cells, you can see there's not as many hair cells. So if you don't have enough hair cells to be stimulated, the signal cannot be sent to the brain. How is a cochlear implant different from a hearing aid? Well, first and foremost, a hearing aid is sending signal through your ear via acoustical stimulation. The sound travels down your ear canal, through the middle ear, and it stimulates those hair cells in your cochlea, which then cause the auditory nerve to fire and send the signal to your brain. When we look at cochlear implants are bypassing our outer and our middle ear, and they're even bypassing our hair cells. They're directly stimulating the auditory nerve. The sound electrically stimulates the auditory nerve and bypasses all the other parts. So when we think about hearing aids in comparison to cochlear implants, it's important to understand that the stimulation type is completely different. Hearing aids is acoustic and cochlear implants is electrical stimulation. So taking a closer look here at how we hear with hearing aids, you can see in this visual, you have the hearing aid. The sound is picked up by the microphones on the hearing aid and processed in the hearing aid. The sound then travels down your ear canal, causes that tympanic membrane to vibrate and the three little bones to also vibrate. And then it stimulates our cochlea, the sound does. Once the sound reaches our cochlea, it stimulates those hair cells, which activate the auditory nerve and send the signal ultimately up to the brain. If we look at how we hear with the cochlear implant, it's a little bit different, as I mentioned earlier. The sound is picked up by the cochlear implant microphones, it's processed, then it's sent to the headpiece, which magnetizes to your internal implant. That signal is sent to the internal implant, and electrical signals stimulate the auditory nerve. The signals from the auditory nerve are then sent to the brain. So ultimately, what is the goal of a cochlear implant evaluation appointment? Our goal as audiologists is to see if you are a candidate for a cochlear implant. What will happen at this appointment is your audiologist will first and foremost get to know you and your history with hearing loss and your history with using hearing aids. Your hearing aids will be assessed to ensure that they're providing the appropriate amount of amplification for you. If it's determined that your hearing aids aren't providing the appropriate amount of amplification, you'll be fit with some hearing aids from the clinic to borrow during the appointment. Following that, you'll be taken to a sound booth for a series of tests with your hearing aids on. During this testing, you'll be asked to repeat back words, sentences, and you'll be asked to respond when you hear the tone or the beep. If you have balance issues or are 65 years old or older, you will also undergo a balance test following your evaluation appointment. So what happens if it is determined that you are a cochlear implant candidate? Your audiologist will review with you realistic expectations with the cochlear implant. They'll go over the CDC recommended vaccinations prior to surgery. You'll choose the device and manufacturer you would like to go with, and you'll set goals for your hearing with the cochlear implant. What factors can affect your outcomes with a cochlear implant? There have been numerous research studies to show that there are these five factors that can affect your outcomes with a cochlear implant. One of those is your duration of hearing loss, how long you've had hearing loss. Another factor is the status of your inner ear and hearing nerve. This is why your physician will request that you get imaging done prior to surgery to ensure the status of your inner ear and hearing nerve is appropriate. Another factor that can affect your outcomes is the age of onset of your hearing loss or when you were diagnosed with your hearing loss. Along those same lines, your age at the time of implantation can also affect your outcomes. And lastly, any other related medical conditions can also affect your outcomes with a cochlear implant. So always be sure to share all of your health concerns with your audiologist and your physician. So what is your commitment with a cochlear implant? If you are a cochlear implant candidate and you choose to go through with a cochlear implant, what is that process going to look like for you? Well, one thing to know is it's not an instant flip of the switch and you're good to go. There is a series of follow-up visits as well as oral rehabilitation exercises. So in regards to visits, you will see your audiologist for 5 visits following surgery, which is spread out over the year. You'll also have annual follow-up visits after that year. In regards to oral rehabilitation exercises, these will be especially important at first because we have to retrain your brain to hear and also to make sense of that electrical stimulation from the cochlear implant. Oral rehabilitation exercises can include reading aloud, listening to books on tape, and apps. But don't worry, your audiologist will give you a whole packet of different activities you can choose from. The other commitment is, it's really important that with a cochlear implant that you wear it all waking hours. We want to make sure that you're using it all waking hours because that helps your brain be able to adjust to getting used to that sound. So what are the CDC vaccination recommendations prior to surgery? The CDC recommends 2 vaccines prior to surgery as a preventative measure. These vaccines are Prevnar 13 and Pneumovax 23. Prior to your appointment for your evaluation, we recommend that you please call your primary care provider to see if you've received these vaccinations, and if so, bring in the record of them. If you've not received them and need a prescription to get them, we'll provide that to you at your appointment time. So how do you select your cochlear implant manufacturer? Well, there are three different cochlear implant manufacturers: Cochlear Americas, Advanced Bionics, and Medel. One thing to know is that one manufacturer is not superior to the other. All three offer safe and effective devices. So one thing to know when choosing your cochlear implant manufacturers is to know that there are commonalities among all three. One commonality is that you'll get two sound processors regardless of the manufacturer. So at your time of surgery, you'll get two sound processors. That's the external component. The reason for that is we want to always make sure that you have a backup processor. We never want you to be without your ears. Another thing to know is that all three cochlear implant manufacturers are MRI compatible. Additionally, all three manufacturers have Bluetooth capabilities. They all have apps for your smartphone, and they all have similar assistive listening devices and accessories. So if they have all of this in common and they're all safe and effective, how do I choose my cochlear implant manufacturer? Well, it really comes down to what features are important to you based on your lifestyle and your listening goals. For example, some manufacturers have compatible hearing aids, some have different style sound processors. It really comes down to what you're most drawn to and what's important for your lifestyle. For additional information on cochlear implant manufacturers, you'll see listed here the phone numbers and emails. You're more than welcome to reach out to these manufacturers to get more information. And we highly recommend you do your research before you come in. So, how can you prepare for your cochlear implant evaluation appointment? First and foremost, come to your evaluation appointment with your hearing aids and vaccination records. We want to see that you've had those two vaccines that the CDC recommends. Additionally, understand that you're going to undergo testing with your hearing aids to determine if you're a cochlear implant candidate. If you are determined to be a candidate, you will select your manufacturer and learn more about realistic expectations with a cochlear implant. Come prepared with any questions you may have. We look forward to seeing you.
Hi, I'm Erin, Associate Director of Education and Global Hearing Health here at the House Institute Foundation. Thank you for watching our video. If you would like to support research, education, or global humanitarian efforts, please consider donating by clicking the link in the description box below. Be sure to check out our other videos, like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can get notified anytime we post. Thanks.